Shalom to everyone. Today we're learning Zera Shimshon, Parashat, Vayishlach, letter Dalet. And today's sponsor for the Shi'ur is Mr. Yosef Ilyabaev. HaShem should give him bracha v'atzlacha. The Leilu Nishmat of his dear father, Melo Shalomo, Ben Ima Shalom, and his grandmother, Ima Shalom, Bat Tova. And Leilu Nishmat Eliyahu Ben Sana. And also, Amavdil Ben Chaim Lechaim should be the Fuah Shlema, Lechol Chol Am Yisrael Bichlalam. Eliyahu. The Mikre Baris Ben Lea and the
Tony about Miriam, please.
Bella Bat Esther, and also
Sonia Bat Miriam.
I can't hear you.
Sonia Bat Miriam.
Sonia Bat Miriam.
Thank you.
Lucham Per Malka.
Lea.
Bat Chana Serel.
Alisha Ben
Rachel. Alisha Ben Rachel. וגם אלישע בן לחל רפואה שלמה. גם אילנה בת דיינה, רפואה שלמה. סלאבה שמחה בן לוזו. וגם לחל בת דורה. וגם רפאל בן ציביה, ורב דין. ורב דין.
רבי ג'ון. רפואה שלמה.
And also, Larissa Leah Batamar and Luisa Batzilpo. And also Mr. Lippman, Yosef. I don't know how to do it.
Yosef Leib Ben Saralaya.
Yosef Leib Ben Saralaya. Rafa Shlema. And also Rafa Shlema Chucholem Yisrael Vecheni Ratzom Adoman.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Rabbi Eliyahu Meir ben Nafal Baruch Hu is dead. Toch Hashem Ha'olam. Rabbi Aaron Wolkin ben Esther. 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 Okay. Let's go. Please mute yourselves, everyone who is on Zoom. And we're starting. You should know when Hashem does something good for a person gets excited. Once he gets excited, he gets inner happiness. Or person is in fear, he gets inner happiness. Not inner happiness sometimes, but inner connection. And he reaches the 50th level of Bina, of understanding. But inside the 50th level of understanding is Shechina. The 15 gematria is letter Nun, 55-0. The 50 gematria is letter Nun, and the living is the word Dar. Dar is like Dira. He lives there, he stays there, remains there. This is where the word neder comes from. When a person makes swearing or promising, when a person swears or promises, he makes neder. He swears or he promises. Anytime when he swears or promises, he uses Shechina with him. He's like obligating Hashem in his promises and in his swears. So that is called neder. Neder from the word nundar. Inside your intellectual mind, there is a Shechina there. Where? Inside the 50th room. It says nun sha'arei bina. There's 50 level of understanding. Inside the 50 year, there is Shechina. That is called Nun Dar. Yaakov Avinu is going to Lavan's house. Is he nervous? Of course. He learned 14 years to be prepared to go to fight with Lavan. Who is Lavan? Person's heart has 32 ways of desires. I want this, I want that, I want money, I want car, I want house, I want name, I want respect, I want money, I want to rob somebody, I want to kill somebody. Want, 32 ways of wanting. 32 ways of wanting is all corruption of the desires. This is why the heart is called how? Hebrew? Lev. How much is Gematria? 32. Why? There's 32 ways of corruption. But Lavan was in 50th level in impurity, controlling 32 ways. This is called Lavan, Lamed Bet, 32, and Nun is 50 of 50th level of impurity. So Yaakov Avinu, in order to go head and head with Lavan, he had to spend 14 years learning Torah, not going to sleep, but falling asleep. Means he was sitting and learning. If he falls asleep, but he doesn't go to sleep. He doesn't go on the bed to sleep. So it's 14 years of learning end up to be 28 years. Because he learned day and night. Thank you. So this is how Yaakov Avinu wants to be sure to go fight with Lavan head and head. So he had to sleep by Ma'arad HaMachpelah. When he put his head down, Hashem made a ladder from his head, from where he's sleeping, from the ground, until Kisei HaKavod, to show him that angels going up and down the ladder, according to some of Hashem, angels were Moshe and Aaron. Hashem showed him how Moshe and Aaron were, how Moshe Rabbeinu was on 50th level in Kiddusha, in holiness, and he was able to bring the Torah down. Yaakov, now you're holding there. So this is why Yaakov Avinu, how many rocks he put under himself? Midrash Rabbah says 2 rocks. Why? Because there were 2 tablets. So he was commemorating Torah. How do we know? How do we say, and he slept there? Vayish. Huh? Vayishkav b'makom ahu. What's Vayishkav? 5 letters. Ve, yuchin, ve, yesh, kav. What's kav, chav, bet? 22. And there is place that 22 letters of Torah coming out here. So Yaakov Avinu saw the giving of the Torah here. Why Yaakov Avinu saw it here? Because he had to be sure that he has 50 level of understanding to go head and head with Lavan, who has 50 level of impurity. So now, Yaakov Avinu, he had to be sure that he is in 50 level of understanding in holiness in order to undo 50 level of understanding of corruption of Lavan. Because Lavan was impurity. If you think the biggest guy who was magician in the Torah is Bilam, you should know Lavan was his teacher. This is why Yaakov Avinu had to go head and head with him. Do you know, before Yaakov Avinu went to Lavan, Rivkai Imenu sends a messenger to say, my son, come back. The way we got married through sending Eliezer, we're going to send Eliezer again. Yaakov Avinu said, no, I'm going to battle this Lavan head and head, and I'm ready for that. Do you know what I'll tell you? You know, it was my big mistake was a few days ago. I was in one yeshiva. I wanted to bring all these points in the yahrzeit, but unfortunately, over there, people not holding in the level that we're holding here in shul. Because here, we learn deep stuff. We're already somewhere above. And it's a big, big plus. You should know that. Each one of you is special. Because things that I say here, I cannot say it outside. I say outside, people looking at me like, come on, what happened to him? He didn't sleep 3 days? Well, what's going on with him? He's hungry? He's thirsty? He doesn't feel well? What's he saying? You know, people think I'm drunk. But I'll tell you one thing you should know. Don't take it simple. You come here today to learn. By you walking here, maybe a certain kid who did not believe in Hashem saw you going to yeshiva, going to learn Torah, he got motivated and you saved his life. You don't even know. And you saved his soul. So Yaakov Avinu, he was not there by his mother's funeral. He did not see how his mother passed away. He did not go to his mother and father when the mother was alive. Why? Why you don't go there? You don't care about your mother? Of course he does. So why didn't go? Listen to this answer. He said, Lavan is a big, dirty soul that has millions of holy souls inside of him. And I have to go take all those souls out. How the Torah in this parsha calls souls? Tzon, sheep. Yaakov gave up his life for the sheep. He made different type of woods, coloring woods, white and black and black and white and this and that. No. This is Torah talking to you in hidden way. Yaakov had to go to take save souls from him. He says, to save souls, I'm willing to do such a big risk that I'm not even going to be spending my time with my mother. And he went, and it says, Yaakov saved billions and billions sheep. He eating in his sheep, in his barbecue. We're talking about Yaakov went there to take the sheep. Which sheep? Us from Lavan. He took 12 Shuvatim out of Lavan. In this 12 Shuvatim, biggest rabbis in the world come. Even Moshe Rabbeinu comes out of there. Even Aaron HaKohen comes out of there. From where? From Lavan. I'm sorry. From Yaakov Avinu going head and head fighting with Lavan. I'm sorry to say, but you should know. This is all introduction. You should know. Every one of us has his own Lavan in his life. Yaakov fought with angel. Every one of us has that angel in our life. What did Yaakov ask you? What did he ask you? What is your
name?
What is your name? What was his name? Did he say his name? Angel said his name. You know, Yaakov fought with him till the morning, right? He said, let me go. I need to go praise HaShem. My time, the only time I have praising HaShem once in my history time. Let me go. He said, no, until you don't tell me your name. Some say he said, play, Peli. Some say he said, this, that. Lemai said, he did not give his name. You know why? Huh? Every cycle, every generation, the name of this Malach changes. Sometimes Rabbi Esav. Sometimes Rabbi Ishmael. Sometimes Rabbi Ahmadinejad. Sometimes Rabbi Bin Laden, sometimes Rabbi Hitler, sometimes socialism, sometimes communism, all this idealism, all this ism, all this is this Satan. And unfortunately, every one of us, we have to fight with him. This is why we learn Torah. How to learn from Yaakov to fight. You know, why do we say, how do you say Jew in Hebrew? Tell me, how do you say Jew in Hebrew?
Yehudi.
Yehudi, Jew. Chazak Baruch. Why do we say, Kol Yisrael, Yesh Laim Chelek, Leolam Haba. Every Israel has share in the world to come. Stop. What happened to Yehudi? Say, every Yehudi, every Jew has a share in the world to come. Torah says, no, you got it wrong. Why? In order to have share in the world to come, you got to be Israel. When Yaakov became Israel? When he beat the angel? In order to get title of Israel, you have to beat your angel. That's what is this. Now we'll continue. Yaakov Avinu. Before going to Lavan, he makes a promise. And he says like this. B'chol asher titen li, aser ha'asrenu lach, Hashem, whatever you will give me on my way, I will give, what's aser? 10%. I will give you 10%. He said, Hashem, whatever you give me, I will give you 10%. The question is, why does it say the word aser two times? Huh? Why is it aser asrenu lach two times? Double the money. V'chol asher titen li, aser asrenu lach. Anything Hashem, you'll give me, I'll give 10 to you. Okay, let's figure out what Yaakov Avinu said today. Zera Shimshon will start right now. It's not going to take more than 15 minutes. You ready? Rav Baruch Abraham, are you ready? Thank you for coming. Thank you everyone for coming. You have no idea. You have no idea how much happiness you give me. Sometimes you see me scream, yell. It's not because of you. It's because maybe sometimes I'm not prepared fully. This is why I scream and yell. It's not to do with you. It's my inner upsetness. Okay, so get it right. Don't be upset. We're still same brothers, same friends, close friends. And you have no idea, every step you put here, it's not less than Yaakov Avinu putting steps going to Lavan. Why? In American world, that you walk, you have no idea how much in dirty streets you put holiness. In dirty roads, you put Kedusha. And any kid that belongs to Klal Yisrael walks there, he feels Kedusha and he gets motivated. He doesn't know you, you don't know him. That's the biggest tzedakah you can get in life. Now let's go inside. Dalet. Midrash Yalkut. In Yalkut Shimoni Parashat Vayishlach Remez Kufl Amet Gimel says, Ala Pasuk Vayavek Ish Imo Adalot HaShachar. And they were fighting Angel and Yaakov until the dawn. Until the morning rises. And Vayavek, it means the dust. The dust went till Shamayim. It was such a big fight. Okay. Lakach Yaakov et kol ma'aser mikneu v'shilach biyadav adav v'natan le'esav. Yaakov Avinu got all together 10% of whatever he made in Laman's house and he sends it as a gift to Esav. Stop. Who did he promise to give 10%? He said, Aser asrenu, 10th. I'll give to you. And who is he giving to?
Shem.
Who is giving to? Esau. He's giving to Esau. How is this possible? Baruchim Abayim, right person in the right place. We need a lot of fixing with the cameras, but not now. Please see. Thank you. לקח יעקב את כל מעשר מקנהו ושילח ביד עבדה ונתן לאסב. And he sent it to his servants and he gave it to Esav. אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא, השם said to him, יעקב, עשית את הקודש חול. You made holy mitzvah of מעשר, holy objects, holy money. And you give to Esav, you made it mundane, not holy. Amar lefanav, Yaakov Avinu says, Ribono shel olam, master of the universe, ani machanif larasha, I am giving bribes to Rasha, bishvil shelo yargeni, so Rasha does not kill me, atkan leshono, until here is the language of the Midrash. Kosher. Zera Shimshon says it is a little bit difficult. Lama lo shalach mishelo? Umati rutsu ze. Why you want to send? Send something from your own stuff. Why are you sending from the ma'aser? You have 90% your produce. Give from your produce. Why are you giving from ma'aser to him? Give from yours. And what? What's the excuse? So Esav doesn't kill me. What kind of answer is this? You give holy Sefer Torah to Esav's hands, so he should not kill you? This is how it goes these days? The question is, it was really, 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 real Maaser? Let's see. Vayishlomar, and the answer is, Demitchila kacha hayta da'ato shel Yaakov. In the beginning, when Yaakov is going to Laban's house, already in the beginning, he made a commitment in his brain. La'aser et kol mamono shekana bechutz la'aretz. He said, any money I made in chutz la'aretz, to give 10%, lefi she'aya tachat chelek hasarim. Ra'ui latet lahem chelek kede shelo yikatregu alav. One thing you should know. Comes Ramban, and Ramban says, I'm sorry, you don't have to throw chairs on me. You don't have to get angry and leave. Don't be upset. It's not me. It's Ramban. When I learned with Aaron Wolkin, Zikron Levracha, around 18, 19, 20 years ago, he mentioned this Ramban. Until today, this Ramban is ringing in my ears. And you see it inside Chumash. When you live in Israel, you make money, you get money directly from Hashem's hands. When you live in America or anywhere in the world, but Israel, angels give you. You're not getting directly from Hashem. You get reward, you get payment from the angels. Yaakov Avinu says, I am living with Laban, where? Chutz La'aretz, out of the borders of Israel. And who is giving my payment? Angels, servants of Hashem. So when angels give you, they are here to harm you. So he said, since angels give me and they might harm me, I want to give this money to Esau to save myself from harm.
Right. That's deep.
I'll repeat it one more time. Look inside Zera Shimshon. I'm reading. In the beginning, when Yaakov was leaving from father's house, already then he said, Hashem, whatever you give me, 10% I give you. Why? Because whatever I'm going to be making out of Israel, it's not from you directly, it's from the angels. Anything I get from them, I'm easily to get hurt. In order for me not to get hurt, I'm going to send this all to Esau. La'aser et kol mamono shekana bechutz la'aretz. Lefi she'aya tachat chelek asarim in chutz la'aretz, in America or anywhere else behind, besides Eretz Yisrael. You make money, you're not making money directly from Hashem. You're making money from angels. Ra'ui latet lahem chelek. And it's worth it. It's important to give them some share, to close their mouth. Did you ever hear that you give to angels something to close their mouth? Patience. Sir, you deserve a give big, big hug. You know why? This is exactly the answer he brings. And I'll show it to you right now. You give back to angels to close their mouth, so they should not speak bad about you to Hashem. Hashem, look, he made so much money. Now he's not giving even 1%, Master. When you give them 10%, you close their mouth. They're not even going to speak about you to Hashem. Where do we see that? Look what it says inside. Top line. Goral echad la Hashem. V'goral echad la Azazel. Where we learn this from? From Yom Kippur. We take two the same goats. Identical twins. One is for Hashem. One is La Azazel. Huh? Azazel, you respect like Hashem. I have no choice. Why? Close his mouth. On the big judgment day, I don't want him to speak bad about me. Who will learn this from? Yaakov Avinu. Do you see how Yaakov Avinu does one thing and brings big sign to his children? Ask yourself a question. Is there anything I do in my life that I bring big sign to my son, to my children, grandchildren? That tomorrow they'll say, my great-grandfather did this. I need to continue this way. It's a big question. I'm sure when you get already stick in your hands after you are 99.9 years old, your son will look at the Zera Shimshon class and say, whoa, look at this. My grandpa was in the shiur. I don't go to shiur. I will go to shiur. Let's go speed up. Mishum hachi, ba'al ha-ta'amim nitchakem la'aniach tibcha tachat eser. Look at this. Look inside. You see, tibcha, like this sign. Aser, like aser, asrenu lach, like separates between aser and asrenu. When person, some say that was Moshe Rabbeinu, it's alachal Moshe Mishinai. When it was put ta'amim on the Torah, signs to the Torah, some say that was done by Anshei Knesset HaGedola. Okay, so when they were putting signs on the Torah, they put aser. Tibcha, tibcha under aser, why? In order to separate from the word aser to asret. First aser to second aser. Why? Look what it says here. Mishumachi. Ba'al ha-ta'amim nitchakem la'anich tibcha tachat aser. Tachat aser. A person who was putting ta'amim, he put aser separate from aser. Kedil afrit ben aser she'uchol la'aserenu lecha she'u kadosh. In order to separate from the word aser, asrenu lach. Aser is mundane, asrenu lach is holy. To make difference between you give 10% to not holy, to 10% to holy. So Yaakov Inu knew he's giving to Esau, not holy. This is why it says aser, to show you it's not holy 10%. Not holy 10%, I gotta give to him. Why? So angels deal with him, not me. Shezen itkayem be'isur abanim. And what happened? He said, since 10% I'm giving with my money, I'm going to give 10% with my son to Hashem. Now look at this. He gives, you know, when I read it daytime, it was a little bit not so clear. Now it's clear. Hashem. When Yaakov Avinu gave 10% with not holy, who he gave 10% not holy? To Esau. Then he gave 10% holy to Hashem. What he gave 10% holy? He said, Hashem, you gave me 10 sons, I give you one of them.
Levi.
But even in here, Yaakov Avinu had a mistake. Where was his mistake? Huh? He said, I'll give you from everything 10%. Means money and children. But he didn't have only 10 sons, he had 12. So from other two, he had to give also one. Since he didn't do it, this is why brother sold Yosef.
No.
But we'll go to this one other time. Let's go further. This is why there's recording, don't worry. משום האחי בעל הטעמים נתחכם להניח טיפחה תחת עשר כדי להפניד בין עשר שהוא חול לעשרנו לך שהוא קדוש שזה נתקיים באיסור הבנים דהיינו לוי יעקבינו said Hashem I'm giving 10 not clean percent to Esau but to you I'm going to give 10 clean percent one of my sons which is Levi. Levi who he became servant of Hashem. You bring Korban, Kohen Levi take from you and they take care of your Korban. Why did I say Kohen Levi? Because Kohanim come out from the Shevet Levi. Kedita be'alkut sham. As it says over there in Remez Kuf Lamed. Lo chata Yaakov. Lefi shekevanato haya kach mitchila. Yaakov Inu never sinned because from the beginning, originally his intention was like this. Him calls it. HaKadosh Baruch Hu aman lo. Asite et HaKadosh Chol. But even if so, Hashem said, Yaakov, you give 10 holy percent to Esav, which is you took holy and made it not holy. Shelo haya lecha likroto b'shem ma'aser. You shouldn't have called it ma'aser. Why did you say aser asrenu lach? I will give ma'aser, ma'aser, ma'aser to you, Hashem, ma'aser to my brother. Why did you give ma'aser, the word ma'aser, holy object, to your brother? Why did you even call it holy? Ve'oden also, lo haya lecha ladbiko im asrenu lach. You shouldn't have connected with the statement of I will give 10% to you, Hashem. Why did you put together? Shelule hatamim haya nishma sheben aser uben asrenu yelecha dehainu laHashem. So because wouldn't be like this, would be aser asrenu lach. I will give 10% to you. It means everything is for Hashem. 3 minutes will be done, guys. Patience. Guys, three minutes. Put it down, 3 minutes. As our Chachamim explained.
Guys, hello.
Shefrish Chomesh. Yaakov Avinu gave not 10%, he gave 20%. V'yesh kan makom laz labriyot. And now people could make fun of Yaakov Avinu. It's like embarrassment. Sheyomru shema shekvar nadate laHashem chazate l'shulcho el Esau. As if he promised to Hashem and he gave it 10% out of this to Esau. Omnam Yaakov yesh lo tirutz al zeh. But Yaakov has answered to this. She'en kan makom lelaas klal. Yaakovinu doesn't have any place for shame. She'adavar yidu she'shem ma'aseh eno chal al davar shelo ba b'shuto shel adam. You cannot have giving ma'aseh from the fruits if fruits never reached your hands. You give ma'aseh from something that reaches your hand. But whatever money Yaakovinu will do or whatever ships he will have, he didn't have it in his hands yet. Ela shebedmai hakalu hakalu kmo shepasak Rambam. But only in the fruits that is not separated 10%. Only Chachamim were lenient over there. How quotes Rambam in Perek Tet Melchot Maaser al Chazayin. Ha mazmin et chavero sheyochal etzlo. If person invites his friend to eat by him, and he doesn't know if the owner of the house gave 10%, Omer me'erev Shabbat, from Friday before Shabbat, he should say, Ma she'ani atid la'afrish la'machar, harehu ma'aser. Wherever I'm going to be on Shabbat, eating in his house, and I'll be separating, that should be ma'aser from before Shabbat. The thing is, how can you separate now when you will eat tomorrow? It didn't reach to you. Over there only, Chachamim were lenient, saying that even fruits did not reach to you, could give 10% from there. But money, yeah, money, Yaakovinu didn't make it. How can he give 10%? To show you, he didn't mean the real maaser. This is what he's going to. Only you allowed to do these kind of conditions when it comes to the fruits. When it's still not in your possession. Aval bevadai. Eno matne ela al davar shebishuto ad kan lashono. But only you could make conditions when something is in your possession. One more short paragraph and we'll finish. 1 minute, let's go. Vim ken, if so. Masha amar Yaakov v'chol asher titen li'asher asranu lach. This is what Yaakovinu said. Whatever you give me, I'll give you 10%. Adain eno klum, achef nishenu. If fruits or money, if money and animals did not reach Yaakovinu's hands, there is no maaser here. You cannot give 10%. How can you give 10%? You say, Hashem, whatever I'll make in 10 years, I'm giving 10%. 1 second, question to you. Does he have it now?
No.
No, so it doesn't mean real maaser. Ulik shef nishenu, kmo shechashav b'da'atov. And when he was separating, he was thinking in his mind, and when he was separating animals to give to Esau, he said, this is ma'aser for Esau. Iglai milta lemafreya, shelo nitkaven ela la'achanifo, latet lo chelek yafeh, sheshmo ma'aser. He already from the original, from beginning, he already had his mind, whatever I'm going to give later on, just to save myself from Esau. I'm just calling it ma'aser, but it's not real ma'aser. Aval be'emet lo chal alav klal. Ma'aser, you cannot say because it's not ma'aser. V'diyuk ha'katuv u'kach. Ma she'eten lecha achzod liklo alav she'ma'aser b'shad ha'aflasha. Whatever I'll give to Esau later in 10, 20 years, whenever I'm going to see him, that whatever I'm going to give him, I will call it ma'aser. But it's not real ma'aser. U'ma she'en ken be'oto she'natati le'esau. V'zehu aser asrenu lach. But Hashem, whatever I give you, this is original maaser. Whatever I'm giving to Esau, why am I giving to Esau? To close his mouth, that I shouldn't get hurt by the angels talking bad about me to you, Hashem, making janganozi between me and you, Hashem. So I'm giving it just to close Esau's mouth, that Esau's mouth and the bad angel's mouth. So what do we learn from here? Whenever you go to do mitzvah, you have to make sure you concentrate to close bad side's mouth also. This is the reason why when we're at tefillin, we have string coming out. What is that? To remember we did golden calf. Why do we remember? Oh, Satan, if you open your mouth, here you close your mouth, and now I need to pray to Hashem. Hashem should help us to learn and grow into Torah. Please stop the shiur. Stop the shiur.
חזק וברוך.